Welcome to another Bforartists 4 version 4.0.1 official release. This is the long format of the video release that shows the latest from Blender 4.0.1 and 4.1.0 in development. So what's new? We have a new splash screen by Kumarai, who got first place in the Discord splash screen competition hosted by yours truly, Andre Stevens. Second place we had White Rooster Productions, with his piece that he ended in the last competition, and due to the bonus points, he came to second place. And with that, we have third place by Ethan Avila, a newcomer who's got a very excellent piece. It was very hard to judge with my friend Plebs, but we managed to come to a conclusion. So next time, in the next splash screen, it could be you. This particular release is about the new default assets, Shader Node Kit procedural node groups, kindly created by Iyad Ahmed, who's one of our core developers, and the thumbnails created by myself. This particular pack, you have up to 97 new nodes to create new procedural materials. This is a toolkit where you can use different color nodes, mapping nodes for texture coordinates, mask nodes for baking edgewear, patterns for new types of patterns that you could use for your materials, the shader utilities, different types of shapes for new patterns, which are all procedural too, and utility node groups, which are very powerful for helping you get more out of your procedural materials for free. With this particular release, we also have a new presentations add-on that turns scenes into slides. So now you can create your scenes as a slide and use them in a 3D space with animation to however way you want to create your presentation. We also have node editor improvements, thanks to Blender, with a new type to search operator and new geometry nodes. To take a closer look in the nodes editor, when we go into a menu, we can now press any key on the keyboard and it will start typing immediately. We can also access this operator, the search operator, from any add menu inside of the interface. The new nodes that are included are the utility rotation nodes, the mesh read write nodes with is edge smooth and set shade smooth by edge and face, and the also points to curves node under the curves category. We also have new geometry node group tools where you can create act once operators in the 3D view header. We also have new geometry node group modifiers exposed and a new add modifier panel, which exposes node groups in the modifier stack add menu in the properties editor. To take a closer look, in the non-categorized area, we also have the tool available here. And we also, in the properties editor, in the modifier stack, add a new modifier, and we can add node groups included by the asset library or marked assets from the geometry nodes tree. To do this, you just have to go in here, and you can now get selection, set selection, get the 3D cursor, get face sets, and set face sets, all underneath the new tools mode available for object, edit, sculpt mode with mesh and hair curve types. We also have new bone collections with the bone collection manager, bone collection operators, and pose and edit mode colors and management, so that in pose mode or edit mode, we can have different colors per bone set and different layers. To take a closer look, you can see these inside of the new bone collections panel on the right, with your operators underneath the move to bone collection system, or underneath the bone collections area where you can remove bones from different or add bones to others or assign them to new. We also have a new modifier add menu for Blender with a new type to search. In this case, you can now use the search operator to search for your modifiers or type to search. We also have sequencer retiming with a conditional operator user experience within the user interface to help you smooth the workflow, and a new equalizer audio modifier. Take a closer look in the video editing sequencer. We also can now select clips, add different keyframes to time and retime your shots. And we also have the ability to add the equalizer to your audio strips. In this particular case, when you select a strip that is not able to be retimed, the interface will now let you know. We also have new F-curve operators with handle selection and blend operators. To take a closer look inside of the animation area, We can now select keyframes with the F-curve editor by selecting the handles or by selecting the key. And we also have the ability to blend with a number of different new ways. And within the 3D view editor updates, we also have sub overlays for the edit modes and different types of things. So when I'm in an edit mode, I now have two separate panels. This is consistent throughout all modes. We have new normal shading changed for the objects so that now you can apply an auto smooth once and it's not reevaluated multiple times. We also have a din topo improvement to set detail size directly from the interface, which previously was a hidden operator. And we also have other hotkeys to improve weight painting, where we can subtract and add directly. So what other updates come from Blender? With this particular release, we have a new Eevee with new screen spaced reflections and global illumination, mesh displacement, environment lighting, and soft shadows with emissive objects. So the new Eevee has bounce light, where we can take a closer look at the displacement with emissive objects and the light bounced from around the world, which is screen space, but still quite cool. This art is provided by Aaron Yart. This release also comes with a new color transform inside of the color management so that you can have AGX with your view. Have a closer look. When we use full-blown lights with a little bit of color, the intensity is quite powerful. As you can see the red light here, with AGX, this allows us to bottle or throttle back the power of the light so that bright lights are actually white and the red colors no longer clip. For more realistic renders, this art piece was provided by Barwin. This release also contains an experimental feature for the new compositor in GPU mode, which allows us to also composite the depth pass with an image pass inside of the compositing. This piece was done by Blemonade. Bforartists comes with 150 additional tasks added to this release. We also have new GUI love from Blender, including a new HUD background, a new font throughout the interface, new node group subpanels, which you can also explore with the mask nodes or from the asset browser, and a new principled shader with hair rendering modes, which also contain their subpanels. And I would also like to say that we had the opportunity to travel to Amsterdam this year to present at the Blender Conference 2023 and present this particular project and much more. Thank you everybody who worked on this particular project, including the developers Reiner, Iyad Ahmed, Sean, and Juso, Blenux, for working with this. And also thanks to the other volunteers who keep this project alive, and thank you for your artwork and the community who have been a part of this project. It has been very symbolic to present, and I'm happy that this release is a culmination of all of this work, all of our things together. So, download Bforartists 4 today at www.bforartists.de/download. It's 100% free.